KwaZulu-Natal Education Department says a large quantity of personal protective equipment has disappeared in Umlazi, Pinetown and Zululand. The department is shocked, saying it will have to spend millions to replace them. For more on this story, I'm joined now on the line by Education MEC Gwazi Mshengu. A very good afternoon to you, MEC. I'm sure this is the last thing that the department needs at this point as you try to get ready to get schools open. And we know that the lack of PPE and the lack of infrastructure has been one of the key reasons why schools are not open as we speak right now. Your reaction to the disappearance, so to speak, of a personal protective equipment and also, I guess, a tied-in question, the measure of security that you've put in place in the various schools?
Well, good afternoon to you and to the viewers. We are correct that this is indeed nothing that expected. The department continue to work hard to prepare our schools for reopening and to ensure that our schools are a safe place to be for teachers as well as the learners. Yesterday, I held a meeting with district directors, which are my meetings that I normally hold with them to try and get the state of readiness per district. And in that meeting, which was in the evening, it appeared that there seem to be challenges of reporting in terms of the quantities of PPEs that were delivered at Umlazi district as well as Pinetown and Zululand. There are a number of schools in those areas which are reported to be still without PPEs and other essentials such as sanitizers, and others have received, but the quantities are not sufficient. And in the meeting yesterday, the district directors indicated that indeed they received the required quantities, but they were unable really to then explain what happened to all those quantities such that we are still remaining with schools that don't have PPEs, as it were. And it was clear that there have been leakages in the system of managing the delivery of these PPEs from the district circuit as well as at the school level. What I want to make it clear is that it's not that probably there was a hijacking of a delivery van to school or whatsoever. There have been really internal challenges that led us to a situation where we're in now.
So are you then saying, MEC, that this could be an inside job? Is this something that has to do with the individual schools? So you're saying that no third party at this moment is suspected of actually having stolen the equipment, at least not from outside of the school environment?
There are no indications of the role of any third party in the moment. I have since directed the HOD to institute an internal investigation on really what happened from the district level, because district directors do confirm that they indeed received the PPE and other essentials. So we need to know what happened from there, who was responsible to receive at the second level, and what happened from there towards the school level. I have also said to the HOD, the investigation must also look into other possible irregularities that may not be that may not have come to the fore at this stage, because I want to preside over a process that is very clean and that is very transparent. But we are also working with the legal service of the department to collate all the necessary information with the intention to open the case with the police.
And when we're talking about the level of the loss, how vast is it? You say here that it's going to take you millions to replace the PPE.
Already the purchase of all these things that we have purchased throughout the province has costed us more than 400 million in terms of the finances from the department side. And obviously the quantities that still have to be verified as to how many are missing. We are looking obviously at spending another million if three districts really affected, and these are our biggest districts in terms of our province. And if they are the ones that are affected, and we're anticipating that again the damage will go to millions. That is why I have said to the CFO now, they must quantify everything that has been lost in terms of numbers and value, so that even when we approach the police, we approach them with all the information that we have gathered.
MEC, it's obviously crunch time right now, and time is of the essence. You've got a deadline of the 8th of June, which is next week Monday, for schools to start. Are you then saying that you're going to try and replace all the missing PPE before then? Because if not, I guess then it means a further delay for those affected schools.
We are now in touch with the provincial treasury as well as National Department of Basic Education to request further assistance, because we initially did not receive any additional funding to procure these COVID-19 essentials. We had to prioritize from the baseline. And if we are to replace these ones now, it will be really very difficult to find any money from within the baseline. That is why we are in touch with the two authorities, which is the provincial treasury as well as the National Department of Education. Obviously, any school in KwaZulu-Natal that does not comply with the non-negotiable will not be able to open.
Thank you so much for your time and for that clarity this afternoon. That's the education MEC Gwazim Shengo in KZN.